what is the most important thing that an EV should have apart from the range and the performance of the bike? The dashboard and software, right? So today let's talk about the best dashboards that we have across the EVs that we have right now in India. We only have three bikes that offer the dashboard on the bikes: Ather, Ola and the Vida. Bikes like Okinawa, Revolt and the rest of the bikes, they don't have dashboards on it, but they have a mobile app to interact with your bike. But having a dashboard on the bike is the beauty, right? So let's see which bike has the best dashboard to offer among Ather, Ola and Vida. Starting with the looks of the dashboard, all three dashboards, they look absolutely stunning. Ather with its integrated dashboard present on the frame of the handle itself. Ola coming with this huge panel of the dashboard with huge bezels on top covering across the dashboard. And the Vida coming with no plastic covering on the dashboard, designing it in a very unique and distinct way. All three dashboards look absolutely stunning. But if you come closer and look at the quality of the screen, I bet you Vida's screen is absolutely stunning. It feels so premium and so solid that you'll fall in love with the dashboard instantly. In comparison, on the S1 Pro Ola, the dashboard feels a bit plastic. It's not that premium quality that you would expect. Ather is in between Ola and the Vida. It's a decent dashboard. It's not the best of its kind. It's not very bad. It's decent. All three dashboards, they come approximately close to 7 inches. Talking of the software and updates of these dashboards, that's a very tough call to make, you see. Because all three bikes have three different interfaces conveying the same information. All three dashboards, they show you same information of the speed that you're riding at, riding mode that you're riding at. It can be eco, ride, sports, walk or even custom driving mode and the hyper riding mode on Ola. And it tells you about the distance that you're driving currently. And it tells you about the total distance that you drove on the bike. You have the navigation. You have the Bluetooth connectivity. And you can save documents on this dashboard. Every feature remains the same. Except the way the design is made on the software is very interesting. If you start with Ather, with a single glance you can find all information that you need for a ride. In comparison, for Ola, you have 3-4 windows across the dashboard that you have to swipe to go through these dashboards to get information from. For Vida, there is no multiple windows. It is just a single window upon which you get all the information that you need for the ride. Now if you compare these three have different approaches. While the Ather started with this fluidic spaces where you have just blocks of information, something closer to the widgets on your smartphone that conveys every information for the ride that you need. And the S1 Pro Ola, they came up with this 4 windows thing where you have to swipe across the dashboard depending upon your need. But in comparison, if you talk about Vida, I personally prefer the Vida dashboard because of the way it looks and the way it is being presented. And once you start using these softwares, you will experience something very different. Your impression on the software that has been built so far takes a very different turn. Starting with Ola, it has a lot of information built in on the dashboard. 4 windows of information you have to swipe in, which is whole lot of information for you to consume while riding on the roads. That I personally felt that this lot of information is very stressful to consume. You have your speedometer, you have your distance, you have your ride modes. If you swipe, you have your navigation, then where you can find your current location and your previous searches, which is good. And if you swipe, you have the ranges that you can get from each of the driving modes and the statistics of each of the ride that you did. This much information, it felt very too much for a person to consume. If you swipe again, you can have the settings, the features on the bike which you can play around with. On contrast, if you go with Ather, from this update that we got last week, it started with this fluidic spaces where it gives you the fundamental information that you need while you ride. The speed, ride mode, your location and your Bluetooth connection if it is there. At a single glance, not loading with information but simple fundamentals. But if you ask me personally, even this is a bit awkward move by Ather, because I own second generation Ather, which is close to 1.5 year old. The problem is the dashboard is built with 1 GB RAM, which makes this fluidic space on Acer dashboard extremely sluggish, very very slow and unresponsive. I'll talk about that later in detail. Coming back to the software and the experience of that, I personally think the champ is the Hero MotoCorp's Vida. It comes with this simplistic design and extremely simplistic swipe gestures that you would get very instantly used to and you start liking it. Because unlike Acer and Ola, these two have certain learning curve for you to get used to these dashboards, to learn where the information is and to use how to swipe to get to that information. For Vida, it is just a single window where you can find the information, and the swipe gestures are also very very simple. If you are not comfortable with the swipe, no worries, you have the buttons on the handle that you can use to play around with the dashboard. I think that is a genius move. Yes, you are loading the handle with a lot of buttons, but these are not the rubbery buttons that you find on Ola. These buttons are very very similar to your PlayStation joystick keys, which means it's pretty easy to get used to these keys. Alright, we have this many features, we have this many windows, the fluidic spaces, blah blah blah. But how much can you rely on the dashboard, and how much is the smoothness of the dashboard? Do the dashboards actually work as smooth as it is shown in the demos? Well, that's an interesting question. The answer is no. It won't work as smooth as it is shown. For example, if you talk about Acer, it lags a lot. It is very very sluggish. I own second generation of Acer 450X. It was only for the first 5 to 6 months that I was relying on the dashboard because it was responsive. It responds instantly. Slowly the dashboard started to get slow. When I say slow, it takes 2 seconds for a click on the dashboard to go to somewhere. If I click on the navigation, it takes 2-3 seconds for the page to load. If I click on my location, it takes 3-4 seconds for it to load. If I send the navigation from my app to the dashboard, it takes forever for the navigation to reach from the app to the dashboard, which previously was a stunning feature of Acer. This used to work lightning fast. Not even a fraction of a second would take for the navigation to transfer from your smartphone to your dashboard. But now, I don't use that feature anymore because the dashboard is very sluggish. On top of that, they have put in this update which completely revamped the dashboard with the fluidic spaces. This is just loading my dashboard very very badly. In comparison, if you see Ola, it comes with 3GB RAM, which is absolutely stunning smooth, I would say. The moment when I saw the dashboard on Ola, I was expecting a slower dashboard that I saw on Acer, a sluggish one, but I was completely surprised with the smoothness of it. It was extremely fluidic, like a smartphone. It was very very smooth. You just love playing around with this dashboard. Swipe gestures are amazing. It's just the best dashboard experience that I have seen. Now, this amazing experience of S1 Pro Ola has been completely broken by the Vida V1 Pro. I was stunned by how smooth the dashboard is. You'll never feel the dashboard is slow and it's not responsive. You just love playing around with the dashboard. It is very responsive, very smooth. I can't express it in words anymore. I highly recommend you to go to a test ride and experience it yourself, because it was a stunning experience. Every swipe gesture, every click was responsive. It was very very nice, and it was so simplistic and intuitive as well. Unlike Acer or Ola, which required some learning curve, for Vida it's very intuitive. You just get used to it from the day one itself. It was that intuitive. The colors of the dashboard. Now, once you start using the dashboard of Acer, you feel that there are only few colors that this dashboard comes with. If I talk about the previous dashboard that we had previous week, it had only two colors, the blue and the black, which is very very boring and very simplistic. In comparison, Ola comes with bright and beautiful colors, and in comparison Vida, it comes with this bright orangish color, which is very joyful color, I feel. Because once I started riding the bike and looking at the dashboard, the joyful color it is, it felt very happy, it felt very satisfying to use the bike. Ola S1 Pro and the 450X Acer, these both come with default ride modes. Four ride modes: Eco, Ride, Sports, Warp on Acer, Eco, Ride, Sports and the Hyper on Ola. Same performance ladder: Eco is the least performing one, but you get most range. Ride mode, slightly better performance but lesser range. Sports mode, slightly increased performance and lower range. Hyper and the Warp with the best performance with the least range. But with Vida, what you can do is you can custom the ride mode that you want. You can custom it, which means you can set limits for the maximum acceleration that you can ride at, the performance that is required from the bike. As per your interest, you can create that ride for your profile. How amazing is that? This feature is extremely stunning. I really want this feature across all EVs. I want this feature across Ola, Ather, because it adds a huge value for a customer. I can design my own ride mode, which is absolutely interesting and genius. Now, these dashboards add a lot of information, add a lot of experience changes for a bike. It uses a lot of navigation assistance. Having these funky, fancy dashboards is extremely interesting and crazy to look at, right? Have you tried these dashboards before on any of the EVs? If so, please do let us know your experience in the comments below.